Thank you. Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor, to heal the contrite of heart, and to proclaim pardon to captives and release to prisoners.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the feast of Jesuit Saint, Saint Peter Claver, a Jesuit of the 17th century, and I'll dedicate the rest of talking about his life in the homily. But we honor him, and in a special way, it's a special day for me, because it's also the day on which I made my first vows into the society 10 years ago. So it's a great privilege to be able to say this Mass and offer it for you all. As we gather around the Lord's table, let us call to mind our sins and so better prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made St. Peter Claver a slave of slaves, and strengthened him with wonderful charity and patience as he came to their help, grant, through his intercession, that seeking the things of Jesus Christ, we may love our neighbor in deeds and in truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, this is the fasting that I wish, releasing those bound unjustly, untying the thongs of the yoke, setting free the oppressed, breaking every yoke, sharing your bread with the hungry, sheltering the oppressed and the homeless, clothing the naked when you see them, and not turning your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, here I am. If you remove from your midst oppression, false accusation, and malicious speech, if you bestow your bread on the hungry and satisfy the afflicted, then light shall rise for you in darkness, and the gloom shall become for you like midday. Then the Lord will guide you always and give you plenty, even on the parched land. He will renew your strength, and you will be watered like a garden, like a spring whose water never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the man who fears the Lord. Blessed be the man who fears the Lord. Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed. Blessed the man who fears the Lord. Wealth and riches shall be in the house. His generosity shall endure forever. Light shines through the darkness for the upright. He is gracious and merciful and just. Blessed the man who fears the Lord. Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. He shall never be moved, The just one shall be in everlasting remembrance. Blessed the man who fears the Lord. An evil report he shall not fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steadfast. He shall not fear till he looks down upon his foes. Blessed the man who fears the Lord. Lavishly he gives to the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory. Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment: love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you: love one another." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today we celebrate the life of a great Jesuit saint, Peter Claver. As I said, he's a saint of the 17th century and a member of the Society of Jesus. So it's a very special feast day for all of us here at the school and all of us who are Jesuits and part of the Jesuit family. So I'd like to talk a little bit about why he's a saint, and not just the biographical explanation, but the theological underpinning also. What is a saint? A saint is someone who sets out to accomplish the mission that has been entrusted to him. That is what a saint is. A saint is someone who sets out to accomplish the unique mission entrusted to him, entrusted to us, in a given particular time period and place in which we live. Each of us has a mission. Each of us has a purpose why we are put in this life. And in Jesuit spirituality, that is the language that we use, a mission. Peter Claver is a young man who, when he met the Jesuits and he was studying under them in the Colegio de Belen, actually, in Barcelona, he perceived in these Jesuits this very great desire to fulfill his mission. He felt that his call, his mission would be fulfilled if he became a Jesuit. And not just a Jesuit, but a Jesuit sent to the new world. He had in his mind, in this deep sense of prayer out of which he operated, that if he set out to the new world, there he would find his mission. He had to leave everything he knew, every place he had ever become familiar with, all of his family, and all of his entire world behind to set out to this new place that was the new world. Not only that, but he had to work within very limited social structures, right? The whole phenomenon of the slave trade was in full steam at this time. Millions of Africans were being imported and sold for price tags. This, however, this corrupt social structure, that is slavery, did not hinder Peter Claver. On the contrary, it was the very place to which he himself saw that God was calling him. This was the place in which his mission would unfold. And it was before this great tragedy that was the slave trade that Peter Claver had an insight. He had a divine calling to tend to these people. And he said, I will take the place of a slave before these slaves. I will become the slave of these slaves. And he tended to them when they arrived on ships, on these great cargo ships. You see all kinds of historical pictures where slaves were crammed in like cargo, like sardines, in a very inhumane way. Peter Claver said, these are the people to which I will tend. The ones that are expendable in the life of the world, the ones that are not regarded properly, this is where the mission of God begins and where a new reality can be created. He's going to the new world, but in some sense, the new world is filled with this great socially corrupt structure. So there's nothing really all too new in it. It's a very poor, corrupt structure. And yet in the shell of this corrupt social structure, Peter Claver creates a new society. He takes the slave, puts his arm around him, and says, welcome. Welcome to the embrace of divine faith. Welcome to faith in Jesus Christ, who loves you and died for you. And he sees the slave that's hungry, and he tends to the slave like if the slave were his master. That's why he says he's the slave of slaves, because he takes on the role of slaves. And the slaves are his masters now. Why? Because this is what God does for each one of us. And in the person of Jesus Christ, he becomes a slave for us, that we may come to know how great his love is for us. Let's ask Peter Claver that we too may be inspired by his missionary career, that we too may accept the socially unjust structures that exist in our time period, but that we may have the creative energy, the feel, the divine call to pursue in the people that we meet, in the places in which we work, to bring about a new society, to bring about a truly new world, a world filled with faith, a world where people serve one another, where they serve the least, those most abandoned, those most neglected, so that no one is left behind, and that all are included in God's divine family, regardless of race, regardless of class, regardless of any particular human categories that may exist, all are included in God's divine family. This is the mission entrusted to each one of us Christians, to bear this good news to all of humanity. And we have plenty of constraints around us. We have the constraints of virtual learning. We have the constraints of a pandemic. We have all kinds of social and political upheaval circulating all over the world. And there seems to be, in some minds, the people that if this election goes about a certain way, a new world will be created. Let's get real. Let's get real. It's with Christian faith in action that the new world will be created, not some political social structure that's going to heal everything miraculously. When each Christian takes up his divine call to fulfill the mission entrusted to him, then a new world will be created. Then new Peter Clavers will operate in our world. And then the world will see once and for all the true beauty, the true goodness, and the true love that Jesus Christ has to offer all of the world in our hearts. God bless you this day. Let's stand now and offer our petitions before the Lord. Let's pray for the church and all those who have Christian faith, that we may bear this light of our faith to all the world and bring about a new presence of God's love. Let us pray to the Lord. Let's pray for our school community and our civic leaders also, not just government leaders, but also healthcare workers, and all those teachers and faculty members that are working here at the school to bring about a greater service of the good. Let us pray to the Lord. Let's pray for all those who are suffering in our community, all the sick, especially Anthony Perotti and Mrs. Chu, that the Lord and all those entrusted to their care may care for them and give them a sign of God's love. Let us pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear and answer our prayers according to your most holy will, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. May our oblation, sanctified by the Holy Spirit, be accepted by you, O Lord, for the salvation of the peoples, for whom St. Peter became a minister of Christ Jesus, your word and our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Peter Claver, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope and Thomas our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Peter Claver, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, let us dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let's pray the prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I have become all things to all, that I might have at least some. I will bless the Lord at all times, his praise always on my lips. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast, the humble shall hear and be become all things to all, that I might have at least some. Glorify the Lord with me. Together let us praise his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me. towards him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. This poor man called, the Lord heard him and rescued him from all his distress. I have become all things to all, that I might have at least some. The angel of the Lord is encamped around those who revere him to rescue them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. He is happy who seeks refuge in him. I have become all things to all, that I might have at least some.
Let us pray. By the power of the sacrifice of your Son, who took upon himself the weakness of our humanity, set our hearts on fire with your love, O Lord, so that having become weak to the weak, we may gain them for Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, vita dulcedo, espes nostra salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Evae, a te suspiramus. Gementes et fuentes in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego advocata nostra in los tuos misericordes oculos ad nos convete. Et Iesum bene
pray for us.